Hi, everybody. My name is Luis Fonan, and I am the CEO and co-founder of Duolingo. And the first thing I want to do is thank you all for being here with us. Everything we do is because of our learners. Now, this is the fourth year that we do our annual conference, Duocon, and it's been going great. Last year, we had some really amazing speakers, and we had over 130,000 people worldwide watch the conference the day of. And this year, of course, it's been a great conference too, and I want to thank all our speakers. But in particular, I want to thank our MCs, Lily and Zari, for having done such a great job today. Thank you, Lily and Zari. And Lily, we're almost done, I promise. Now, this year is a very special year for us. This is our fourth Duocon, but this is the 10-year anniversary of Duolingo. We launched Duolingo 10 years ago. And in the last 10 years, we've accomplished some incredible things. Duolingo is now the most popular way to learn languages in the world. And there's some really amazing statistics. For example, there are more people learning languages on Duolingo in the United States than there are people learning languages across all US high schools combined. And this is true in many different countries. Now, over the last 10 years, many things have changed. For example, our owl mascot Duo has really evolved to become cuter and cuter. So in 2011, poor Duo had chicken legs. Then in 2012, he looked like he was a murderer. In 2014, Duo had a little bit of an awkward teenage time. And in 2019, Duo became a lot cuter, and this is what we have now. Over the years, a lot of people have been asking us if they could get their own version of Duo, their own toy version or a plushy version of Duo. And well, since it's our 10-year anniversary, you asked and we listened. So now you can go to store.duolingo.com and get your own version of Duo. It's a very cute plushie, and you can have your own version of him. Now, many things have changed over the last 10 years, but one thing that has remained the same is our mission. Our mission is to develop the best education in the world and make it universally available. Now, what that means is that anyone, anywhere in the world can learn a language for free on Duolingo, and we're very proud to be able to allow that. One example of our mission in practice is all the work we've done with Ukraine. Since the beginning of the year, the number of people learning Ukrainian on Duolingo has increased by 500%. Now, many of these learners are learning Ukrainian to show support for the Ukrainian people. But many others are doing so because they live in countries near to Ukraine that are getting a lot of refugees. For example, in Poland, there's a lot of refugees from Ukraine that are coming in, and Polish people are learning Ukrainian to be able to communicate with them. We are very proud that we've been able to help during this humanitarian crisis. Now, it's not our intention to profit from this increased demand of people learning Ukrainian on Duolingo. So we've decided to donate all of the ad revenue from people learning Ukrainian on Duolingo to Ukraine Relief. Over the last 10 years, we have been perfecting the way that we teach with Duolingo. We call this the Duolingo method that we use for teaching. And the Duolingo method is very effective and has five components. The first one is on Duolingo, you learn by doing. So as opposed to having to read a bunch of grammar theory or anything like that, the way you learn is by doing. You learn by speaking, you learn by listening, by writing, by reading. And this is grounded in learning science to help your brain learn better. Another component is adaptive learning. On Duolingo, the lessons that you take adapt to you. So if you are getting better and better really fast, the lessons get harder and harder and more sophisticated. If you are struggling a little bit, the lessons get easier and easier. So we have an adaptive learning method. The third component of the Duolingo method is that we really want to form a habit. We've realized that the hardest thing to learn a language by yourself is staying motivated. So we have made Duolingo be as fun as possible and feel as much like a game as possible. So we have bite-sized lessons. We have a lot of gamification mechanics like the streak, and all the progress bars and XP, which are experience points. And all of this makes Duolingo really fun to use. Another component of the method is that we are standards aligned. The Duolingo language learning app is aligned to the common European framework of reference for learning languages. And that ensures that you are learning the things that matter when you're learning a language. And then the fifth part of the method is that Duolingo is very delightful. When you use Duolingo, we just want you to have a smile on your face. So this is why we have all the really amazing animations on Duolingo. This is why we have our cast of characters like Lily and Zari. This is why we have haptic feedback in the app. All of this combined makes it so that Duolingo is a very delightful experience. Now, as a company, we don't always take ourselves very seriously. And this is, you know, something that you saw. For example, Zarya gave a great talk about our TikTok account, which has millions and millions of followers. And it's because it's our owl mascot doing some pretty silly things. And this is just a reflection of how we think of ourselves as a company. Another example of our silliness as a company is our April Fool's campaign from this year. This is a play on some of the memes that have been going around our owl mascot, that if you don't do your Spanish lessons, our owl mascot is going to kidnap your family. So this year, our April Fool's campaign was this video, and I'll just let you watch it.
Has your family been taken by a corporate mascot? Were you extorted by an enormous green owl? Have you been physically or emotionally injured by Duolingo? Did you want to learn a new language but lost your streak and your loved ones? Did you receive disturbing threats such as Spanish or vanish, French or the trench, Japanese or broken knees? If you're a victim of the Duolingo owl, you're not alone. Hi, I'm Peter Francis Manchetti, attorney at law. Over the past decade, I've recovered 537 family members, friends, and precious pets from Duo. Now let me and my elite team of legal professionals at Manchetti & Sons LLC fight for you.
Learning a new language was supposed to be fun and easy. Well, if you've ever been thrown in the trunk of a car and driven across state lines by a huge green owl, you know that there's nothing fun and easy about Duolingo.
Duo took my family. Next, he took my Funko Pop collection. Manchetti & Sons brought my case to trial, and I won $2.7 million, which numbs the sting of never seeing my husband and children again.
Text or call Manchetti & Sons now at 781-STOP-OWL.
That's 781-STOP-OWL.
Manchetti & Sons, call for help right now at 781-STOP-OWL.
Now, let me talk a little bit about some product improvements that we've been making recently. Of course, the biggest one is one that you already saw in another talk at Duocon, where Ananya talked about our new home screen. We're very proud of this new home screen. It is significantly clearer to users, and also it has a lot of really delightful animations, and we are certain this is going to make learning easier and better. So this is kind of the biggest change that we've done over the last several years. We're very proud of it. Another recent change that we've been doing is we've just made the Duolingo experience a lot more social. That is, you are now able to use Duolingo a lot more with your friends. So, for example, on Duolingo now you can follow people, and people also can follow you. And if you follow somebody, you can, for example, congratulate them. So you can send them, you know, whenever something happens, if they reach a 500-day streak, you can congratulate them. And receiving one of those congratulations from one of your friends feels really, really good and helps you keep going on Duolingo. So making Duolingo more social makes it so that people use it more and more and learn a language more and more. Another example of our social features, one that we introduced recently, is our weekly friend quest, where the idea is that you can be paired with one of your friends, and then together you have to reach a goal. You have to, for example, finish 50 lessons or finish 50 perfect lessons over the next week or something. And then if you both do, you get a reward. This is also something that gets people to use Duolingo more and more and be able to learn a language more and more, because now you feel accountable to your friend to continue learning a language. Another improvement that I want to highlight is all the work that we've been doing on our school's dashboard. If you didn't know, especially if you're an educator, we have a dashboard for teachers to use Duolingo in their classrooms. You can find it by going to schools.duolingo.com. We know that a lot of students use Duolingo in the classroom, and there's a lot of classrooms that use Duolingo. And according to our own estimates, in the United States at least, around 40% of language classrooms use Duolingo in one way or another. They sometimes use it as homework. They sometimes use it as a classroom activity. They sometimes use it as extra credit. And so, you know, classrooms use Duolingo a lot. What Duolingo for Schools is it's a dashboard that allows teachers to track the progress of their students while they're using the standard normal Duolingo app. We've made a lot of improvements to Duolingo for Schools, and we hope that teachers really like them a lot. Another project that I want to highlight is the Duolingo English test. Many of you may not be aware of it, especially if you're in the United States, but the Duolingo English test is a standardized English proficiency exam. The idea is that you can take a test, and at the end you get a score between 0 and 160 of how well you know English. We started this project around 5 or 6 years ago for many reasons. One of the big reasons is that our own users who were learning English started sending us emails saying, hey, I'm glad that I can learn English for free on Duolingo. This is great. I wasn't able to afford learning English before, but now I have a problem. I need a certificate that proves that I know English. Could you give me a certificate? And we got enough of those emails that we decided to go and look at the English language certification market. And what we found was crazy. It turns out that literally billions of dollars every year are spent by people certifying that they know English. There's many reasons for why people take standardized English proficiency exams. For example, if you need a work visa in the UK or anywhere in the Commonwealth, you have to take a standardized English proficiency exam. If you want to apply to come to a university here in the United States or in the UK or in Australia or in Canada, you have to take a standardized English proficiency test to make sure that you speak English. We introduced the Duolingo English test about 6 years ago. And the reason we did it was because before the Duolingo English test, the way people used to certify that they know English is they had to take these standardized English proficiency exams. There's a few of them, and they're all very similar to each other. And the way they work is you have to make an appointment to take them. You have to go to a physical testing center to take the exam. You have to pay about $250 to take the exam, and then you have to wait a few more weeks to get the results. So in all, the process was taking several weeks. You had to go somewhere, and you had to pay $250. The reason we thought this was crazy was because most of the people who have to take English proficiency exams live in developing countries. And in a developing country, $250, that's a month's salary. The testing centers, they're not in every city, so you may have to travel to take the test. So we decided we could do a lot better. So what we decided to do was to make our own English proficiency exam, the Duolingo English test. And there are some really big innovations with it. The first one is that you don't have to go anywhere to take the test. You can take the test from your own home using a computer. So this is an online test. The second one is that as opposed to having to pay $250 to take the test, our test is only $50. So these two things combined makes it so that our test is significantly more available. For example, there are entire countries where you weren't able to take the test before because there were no testing centers, but now these people could take standardized English proficiency exams by taking the Duolingo English test. Since we launched the test about 5 years ago, we've gotten a significant number of organizations to accept the results of our test. By now, 4,200 different institutions accept the results of the Duolingo English test. This includes many, many universities. In the United States, for example, most universities that you've heard of accept the results of the Duolingo English test. Columbia and Yale and NYU and Northeastern and Duke and Stanford and MIT, almost every university that you've heard of accepts the results of this test. And in fact, if you take the top 25 universities in the United States by how many international students they have, 100% of them accept the results of the Duolingo English test. This is something that we're extremely proud of. Now, also related to our mission and related to the Duolingo English test, we're really proud that we recently announced a partnership with the UN Refugee Agency, UNHCR, in which we are helping refugees come to college to the United States or the UK or Canada or Australia. Refugees, of course, have a very hard time going to college. In fact, it is estimated that only 3% of refugees go to the university. We want to fix that. And one of the blockers was that particularly for going to a university, you know, like in the US or the UK, one of the blockers was that refugees could not take standardized English proficiency exams. But now they can because they can take the Duolingo English test. And also we're giving fee waivers for them to take it. And we're going even a step further. We're hiring college counselors to help refugees get into universities here in the United States or in the UK. So this is something that we're very proud of too. Now, let me talk about some new courses. So recently, we launched Zulu, so now you can learn Zulu on Duolingo. And pretty soon, we're going to launch a few more. So we're about to launch Cantonese for Mandarin speakers. So if you're a speaker of Mandarin, you will now be able to learn Cantonese on Duolingo. We're about to launch English for Bengali speakers. So this is big in particular in India, so we're going to have a lot more people in India be able to learn English. So we're very excited about all of these languages. And that's it. Thank you so much for spending your time today with us and learning more about our company, and see you next year.